You're watching PTS English News. I'm Stella Chu. Our top story today, a fire broke out at around 10 o'clock last night at a Hsinchu City tire shop. Police arrested a suspect surnamed Chen, who they believed had set the house on fire. His mother, his sister, his wife, and four children, a total of 8 lives, were taken away in this fatal incident.
The accused, surnamed Chen, was suspected of having a quarrel with his family due to dishwashing or money disputes. He was suspected of driving out to buy gasoline, and when he came back, set fire to the entire house. Nearby neighbors still can't believe it happened. According to preliminary investigation, as soon as the four adults found the motorcycle on the first floor was on fire, they immediately rushed to the second floor to save the four children. However, the fire spread rapidly. Firefighters determined that after the adults arrived on the second floor, they might have fainted and lost consciousness and died with the children. Because the floor was lined with flammable wood, the fire was so intense that it burned directly through. The victims' bodies also fell from the second to the first floor.
那因为我刚提到火势全面燃烧的关系，那一二楼的易燃的材质整个被烧穿之后，疑似在二楼的这个前面的居室有八名罹难者的部分，就掉落到一楼的地面。
All of the remains have been identified. The police said that the suspect, surnamed Chen, had burns, was in a normal mental state, had no record of domestic violence, and had previous convictions such as theft and fraud. The deceased include his wife and their 3 children.
我诚心的犯险，为80年是男性，疑似和家人发生口角之后，泼洒汽油纵火所造成。那警方第一时间获报到场之后，即将嫌疑人依现行犯当场逮捕。
The suspect's father came to the scene along with fire investigators. Among himself, his eldest son, who's a volunteer soldier, were both away from home when the fire broke out and narrowly escaped this fatal incident.
Multisystem inflammatory syndrome can affect both children and adults after COVID-19 infection. Shinkong Memorial Hospital recently started treating a person around 30 years old who developed a persistent fever and the inflammation of multiple organs after COVID-19 infection. This patient is thought to be the first case of Miss A in Taiwan.
The COVID-19 situation in Taiwan remains in a plateau. More and more cases of children developing multisystem inflammatory syndrome in children, or MISC, after COVID-19 infection are being reported. Adults can develop this condition too, but it's called MISA. Tsinghua Memorial Hospital recently started treating a person around 30 years old who developed a persistent fever and the inflammation of multiple organs after COVID-19 infection. This patient remains in an ICU and is thought to be the first case of MISA in Taiwan.
他有多重器官发炎的一个现象，发高烧，有休克的现象，有肠胃道的症状，有眼睛的症状，但是他比较没有皮肤的症状，所以还没有办法确定。
Doctors say symptoms of MISC include rashes and conjunctivitis, but fewer than half of MISA patients have skin and mucous membrane symptoms. As multiple organs are affected, it's difficult to diagnose from external appearance. It can also be confused with septicemia, so clinical diagnosis is not easy. Experts say a U.S. study from 2021 showed that if people exhibit 5 major symptoms, including fever, low blood pressure, reduced heart function, and breathing difficulties in the 1 month following recovery, they may have MISA.
主要的表现呢，就是发烧，然后出疹子，可能有腹泻。那另外呢，就是可能会有这个觉得心脏没有力气，血压比较低，或者觉得会喘。那年龄层来讲，还是普遍偏年轻啊，大概是40岁以下的还是比较容易一点。
Experts say the pathogenesis of MISA is still unknown, but it's believed to be caused by a dysregulated immune response. Further research is needed to determine if it's caused by COVID-19 or is a worsening of an existing disease. Taiwan only has clinical guidelines for treating MISC. There are no guidelines for treating MISA.
We'll now bring you some top stories from around the nation. 300 physical summer camps will be held by the China Youth Corps this summer. All campers must present negative rapid test results, and if confirmed cases exceed a certain percentage, the camp will be suspended. The Armaments Bureau allowed the media to test ride the latest Cloud Leopard armored vehicle. The armored troop carrier is priced at more than 94 million NT dollars each, and a total of 305 vehicles are expected for delivery. As countries gradually loosen border restrictions, travel industry operators says the international airline tickets have increased by 30% to 50% on average compared to before the epidemic. The United States Federal Reserve on Wednesday raised its benchmark interest rate by 75 basis points, marking the sharpest rate hike since 1994, as data released in recent days showed no clear signs of easing in inflation. This also led to a rebound in Taiwan stocks on the 16th.
The U.S. Federal Reserve announced a 0.75% rate hike, the largest single rate increase since 1994. The announcement was in line with market expectations, and the short-term bullishness impact led to a rebound in the stock market. The three major indexes ended in positive territory, with the Dow Jones up 303.7 points, NASDAQ index up 270.81 points, and the S&P 500 rose 54.51 points. The three major indexes all recorded their best single-day performance since June 2nd.
It recognizes that inflation is accelerating at 8.6% and is likely to continue to accelerate. In other words, it hasn't peaked. So their decision to raise the interest rate significantly today is still a catch-up because they're still behind the curve.
Rising U.S. stocks also caused Taiwan stocks to rebound on the 16th. The TAIEX opened with a rise of 99 points and reached 16,098 points. The weighted index then rose by 200 points and recovered above its five-day moving average, going as high as 16,209 points. In terms of stocks, electronic companies rose 0.63%, financial stocks rose 0.76%, and TSMC opened at 515 NT dollars, a rise of 9 NT dollars. TSMC reached as high as 516 NT dollars during the session. However, market momentum couldn't keep up, and the market rally stalled slightly.
台股的部分在过去这几天美股破底的情况之下，台股相对的抗跌。换句话说，其实台股其实已经有事先反映到了这个所谓短线利空出尽的一个状况。所以今天呢，这个指数反弹的一个空间就不是很多，因为想买的其实在过去这一两天已经先行进场买了。所以今天弹高上去的时候，反而这个很多卖压就开始出来。Analysts
said that the Fed may continually raise interest rates from July to September, which may once again suppress peak season demand in the third quarter. Thus, the stock market won't have the room for rebound, and investors still need to be cautious.
And now we'll bring you some top stories from around the world. The United States on Wednesday announced a fresh infusion of $1 billion U.S. dollars in weapons for Ukraine that includes anti-ship rocket systems, artillery rockets, howitzers, and ammunition. Australia's new government on Thursday formally committed to a more ambitious greenhouse gas reduction target of 43% by the end of the decade in fulfillment of a key election pledge. Police have found human remains in their search for British journalist Don Phillips and Brazilian indigenous expert Bruno Pereira after a suspect confessed to killing them in the Amazon rainforest. The Food and Drug Administration's vaccine advisors gave a thumbs up to vaccines from Moderna and Pfizer for children under 5 years of age. The outside experts voted unanimously that the benefits of the shots outweigh any risks for children under five, and that's roughly 18 million youngsters. The Centers for Disease Control and Prevention will decide on a formal recommendation after its advisors meet Saturday. And if the CDC signs off, shots could be available as soon as next week.
And we have here 21 yes votes. This is a unanimous vote, and there are 0 no votes and 0 abstain.
An expert panel convened by the U.S. Food and Drug Administration voted unanimously on June 15th to authorize the use of the Moderna and Pfizer BNT COVID-19 vaccines on children under the age of 5. A representative from Pfizer said that a 3-microgram dosage offered 80% protection for children aged 6 months to 5 years. Fever and fatigue were the most common side effects. Meanwhile, the Moderna vaccine is 1/4 the dosage of the adult vaccine.
As children under 4 have had the greatest increase in their risk of hospitalization due to COVID-19 during the Omicron surge, initiating this vaccination series now is vital to start protecting children this summer.
The U.S. has around 18 million children under the age of 5. The U.S.'s Centers for Disease Control and Prevention will make the final decision. The vaccination of this age group at pharmacies or medical institutions may begin as early as June 21st. However, experts warn that 2 doses of the Moderna vaccine only provide about 40% protection, so both vaccine producers are studying the effectiveness of a 3rd dose.
We do feel very confident that the evidentiary standard for benefit for EUA has been met here. But I think, in terms of what the efficacy is, after a 3rd dose, and whether an additional dose beyond that would be needed is going to require a little bit more data.
On June 15th, Chief Medical Advisor to the President of the United States, Anthony Fauci, tested positive for COVID-19. A statement issued by the National Institutes of Health said the 81-year-old Fauci, who is fully vaccinated and has been boosted twice, tested positive in a rapid test and has mild symptoms. He has not been in contact with U.S. President Joe Biden or other senior officials recently.
Thanks for watching PTS English News. I'm Stella Tu. We'll see you tomorrow.